What's up guys, welcome back to another video. Today we have for you an in-season jump training and strength training for volleyball. So like I said, we got some jump training in there. We get a little bit of power and then some strength stuff. So since we are in season, we're not going absolutely crazy, but we are still lifting to maintain that strength and to get a lot of corrective exercises in there. So a lot of pulling to reverse the repetitive motions of volleyball, just make sure we don't have any imbalances. So if you guys enjoy it, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. We post new videos every Tuesdays and Thursdays, so make sure you're subscribed. Keep watching. Hope you guys like it.
All right, starting with pogo, so double leg, single leg, alternating. We're just gonna do 10 of everything. Get the body going with this before we jump into what's next. So we're doing 6-inch double leg box jumps. It's super small because I want it super fast. So as soon as you get on the ground and get off, we're going 10 double leg, and then we're gonna go lateral, still double leg, still as fast as you can. You're gonna go again 10 of these. Keep everything nice and tight. Try not to let your ankle collapse when you touch the floor. Try to keep it nice and stiff, just like we're doing pogos. We're just doing it onto a box. Last 6-inch box jump, we're doing single leg. We're only doing 6 each side. Still try to keep it as fast as you can. It's gonna dip a little bit, but keep it nice and fast. Try not to hold on to anything, but if you need to, you can.
All right, guys, you haven't seen this in a while. What we're gonna do, we are gonna hold it. So one person's gonna hold the band, the other person's gonna be holding this end. He's gonna do a broad jump as I pull it, so it's accelerating his jump. All he's gotta do is stick it. So working on that decel from an accelerated jump.
Next up, we got some depth drops. Start arms high, one leg out, fall off, land in that snap down. Notice how he doesn't jump off, he just kind of falls off. Nice strong landing, pull yourself into that snap down position. Depth drop to release, so you're gonna drop off, same thing. And then you're not doing a jump, you're just kind of doing a release. So just kind of let yourself come up off the ground a little bit, reverse the drop. But like I said, you're not fully jumping. It's just getting you up off the ground a little bit. So I love starting with the release jumps to just kind of get your body going from the drop into a jump, but now we're getting into the jump. So we're gonna start with your typical depth jump. Drop off one time for each leg, and then get into a vertical jump. So the goal here, try to get up off the ground as fast as you can. So you might not necessarily get as high as you can go, but I want you to get off the ground as quickly as you can. Following the vert up with a broad jump. So same thing goes, drop off, get into a broad jump, try to get off the ground as quickly as you can once again. So it might not be the farthest broad jump you can do, but we're trying to decrease our ground contact time here. Another progression, we're gonna go lateral jumps. So if you stick your right foot out, then just jump to your right. Just keep it simple like that. If you're really feeling up to it, then jump each direction with each leg. But if you only have time for one leg goes out, land, jump fast. Combining all of them for the last one, drop, broad jump, lateral jump, vertical jump. Same thing as I keep saying, I don't really care how far you get right now. I kind of just want it to be as fast as you can for every jump. Really work on like land and go nice and quick. We are starting the lift off with a landmine split jerk. We're only doing one a side, and then it doesn't have to be your max. Make it just a little bit difficult, but we're not going crazy, especially because if this is in season, we don't want anything that's super crazy. We just wanna work and get some power going, but still make it a little challenging. And we are partnering that with some shoulder care stuff, so band pullovers. I like to step in the band with one foot, hand over hand grip, go straight up over your head. You don't need to go behind your head, just cut it when you're in line with your body. Keep your shoulders down, don't let them scrunch up. We really wanna work on pulling, since with volleyball, it's a lot of more forward motion. We wanna work on reversing that so we fix imbalances.
Next up, we are doing an opposite reverse lunge. So hold the dumbbell in one hand. That same side goes back into a reverse lunge. You don't have to hit your knee to the ground. Actually, I prefer people to not. That way you have to work on stopping the motion and then returning it. Really squeeze your glute. Make sure your knee doesn't track in as well.
We are doing a stability ball, single leg, hamstring iso. So one foot on the stability ball, one in the air, hips as high as you can. You're holding this position each leg. Make sure you keep your hips nice and high. Really focus on squeezing through your glutes and your hamstrings.
We're doing lateral push-off. So basically a lateral lunge, but we're not going all the way down. We're just kind of stopping it high and then pushing back. So we're here. We stop it high and we push back. I like to keep this leg straight. Like I said, cut it high, push right back. Still the same thing goes, make sure your knee doesn't cave in, hips go back. It's just your typical lateral lunge form. Set three, we are doing, or series three, we are doing pull-ups. Like I said at the start, it's really important we get a lot of back stuff. Volleyball is a lot of forward, so we want to counteract that. So pull-ups, if you can't do pull-ups, you can do banded or assisted pull-ups, or you can always do lat pull-down. Coming next, we're doing a single arm dumbbell row. I like to do it holding onto the cage. You can also do it on the bench. One knee on the bench, one hand on the bench, but we go split stance, row to your back hip, slow and controlled, right? We don't want to go fast, we don't want to release fast. Release should be super slow. Really control it, keep your scap, your shoulder blade engaged the entire time. Keep it retracted as well.
Right, the point is feeling your abs, not to hurt the rest of your body.